Hello everyone, so my name is Yuory and I'm from Cambodia, a country from Southeast Asia, and I'm so excited to be a part of this project because I believe a part of my story can potentially empower women from different parts of the world. Okay, so I want to share my story by begin with my own personal family story, I guess. It's like a history of girls in my family. So girls in my family, I can say I can talk about my grandma. She did not get the chance to, you know, receive a proper education back when she was young. So I think she only finished her primary school and that was it. That was such a little amount of education that she received back then. Because what she did was that she had to listen to her parents who told her to just stay at home and, you know, get married, you know, to have a family and leave the husbands and have kids. That was her story back then. My grandma, unfortunately, she still has the norm inside her head, thinking that a woman should not get a, you know, proper or good education, or to, like, how do we say it? Women should not get much education. So my mom, she did not get a proper education as well. She didn't finish high school. She only finished secondary school. Yeah, I can say that it was very unfortunate for my mom, because my mom always tell me that she wanted to, you know, to go to college and she want to find herself a proper job and live off by herself. However, things, you know, twisted. She got married when she was very young. I bet when she was like around like 18 or something. She was very young back then. So she lived with my dad. She stay at home, take care of me and, you know, all of the household chores. So mostly women in my country are told to just, you know, work around the kitchen, take care of the husband and the kids and stuff like that. That was like a norm back in the past. Things actually have changed right now, but people still have this opinion inside their head of women. Even though a lot of parents have sent their kids to school nowadays, there are still parents out there who encourage their you know, daughters to just drop off school and get married, because they just too scared that if the woman try to study, you know, when they finish their bachelor degree, they go for master, PhD, and PhD, post-PhD, they will never get the opportunity, you know, to find themselves a husband because, you know, their education is too high up. Which I think this is something that people still believe in my country. They believe if I were to, it's a part of the problems right here in my country. But fortunately, things have changed and it's get better. But before it get better, so let's go back to the past a little bit. So in the past, there was this whole thing created for women. I think it's not like an official law or something. It's something that appeared in, you know, literature and everything, and people still studying it right now in public school and in the general education in my country where we study literature and stuff. So there's this whole thing created for women called the law of women, or you can also say it, the rules of women. There's no the rules of men or the law of men. Which women need to, you know, there this whole poem created for women, something that they need to follow. For example, they need to get up before their husband, right? They need to, you know, they cannot just eat before their husband. Their husband have to eat first, and after that they can eat. And like, they're not allowed to walk very loudly. They have to walk very silently and think about the fact that they are women. And the fact that they are born a woman shifted everything, and it's very scary, and it's something that I believe is it's not fair at all. But just like I said, things have changed right now. Women kind of build more power right now, but there's still this norm inside people had thinking that a woman is not as powerful as men in the sense. let's just switch it to, you know, some positive thing that is happening right now. I can see that a lot of women are going to school. Most of my classmates are actually girls, and I'm very happy about that. And I involved in a lot of like social projects and stuff, and I have seen so many girls involved in those kind of projects as well. And people who work for the government and people who work in like healthcare and you know, all of those sectors like engineer and all of those stuff, I can see that a lot of women have involved in those kind of sectors right now. I'm actually very happy. A lot of things have changed since the very past time. I want to talk a little bit about my story, link back to what happened in the society right now. So during my generation, I am very fortunate to actually get the chance to go to school, and I am still doing my bachelor degree right now. I always tell myself, because this is something that my mom always tells me to do as well. She always tells me that both my mom and my dad always tell me that I have to live independently by myself. I don't need to depend on other people. I need to get educated. I need to find myself a good job and live off by myself. Buy myself a house maybe, or a car, and I can live independently by myself. So even though anyone who wants to, you know, abandon me, this is something that a lot of women in my country are afraid of. So they are told to get married with you know, their husband, right? It's like an arranged marriage kind of thing by their parents, and they don't have a job, they don't get educated properly. They ended up having to deal with their husband because they cannot financially support themselves. So they have, even though whatever their husband does to them, whatever the husband do to them, like using violence or abuse or anything, they have to bear with it because they know that they have kids now and they cannot live off by themselves because they don't have the, you know, how do I say it? They don't have the ability to live off by themselves, which is something that I'm afraid of and my parents are afraid of. Thankfully, I'm still doing my bachelor degree, and I even got the opportunity to involve with many projects, like social projects and stuff. Thankfully, I have parents who, you know, understand a lot. There are still parents out there who strictly take care of their daughter. For example, let's say if my parent have a son, or if other parent have a son, the son can actually stay late up at night. They can come home at around, you know, 10 or 11. They don't really care. But if they have a daughter, the daughter have to come home at a certain time because they are not allowed to really go out. This is something that is, I can say, another problem that is happening right now. Parents are too afraid of women going out and staying too late all by themselves, right? However, I have parents who truly understand everything, and they support me, and I involve with many good people and with many social projects. I actually not only am doing my bachelor degree, but I got myself to to earn this golden opportunity to go to study in the United States for a semester through a global youth grad program, which I'm very thankful for. And I believe that no matter who you are, man or woman, you can make anything happen. So I have some projects with myself that I used to do, which I believe it involve women inside as well, although I cannot directly see it by myself. So I used to do several projects, social projects, in which involve regarding like education and scholarship. So I went to different parts of my country to share my own personal experience, and I can see many potential young women out there who want to step up and get educated. Whenever I do like kind of social project, I also look out for women as well. Actually, I've never done anything specifically like a project which I specifically support women, but I used to do a lot of like social projects to help students in general. However, I always pay close attention to women, whenever I see them have, you know, this potential inside their inside themselves that they want to achieve something big, I always you know tell them that everything is possible and anything is, it's just right. We can see a lot of you know, women who step up and they achieve things and stuff like that. I'm currently an English teacher right now in a private school in my country. So I also have a lot of young you know, women who are studying it with, English with me. Sometimes I just give away, you know, some like personal story and also like life lesson to them, in the sense saying that no matter who you are, no matter what you want to achieve, I always say that anything is possible. So I guess I would end this video by saying, by sending a small message to a woman out there. I don't know if this would change anything, but if you ever feel like you are a woman and you do not get treated properly from anyone, you believe that it's unfair that because you are born a woman, I think every woman in the world have your back. Just believe that anything is possible, because if I can make, you know, for example, if you want to simply go to college, if I can make it happen, I strongly believe that you can make it happen as well. So if there is one thing, you can just look at the big thing. If you want to be a president of a country, right? If you want to be a president of the country, let's say if you want to be a, you know, a president of a club, maybe, let's start small, right? Or even you want to be someone who, you know, work for NASA, I think it can be anything that you want to do in life. I believe that anything is possible. So no matter who you are, man or woman, your sex doesn't matter at all. What really matters is from you in the inside. I believe that it's going to be hard in the society who do not really value women. Fortunately, in my society, people have changed a lot, and they actually put more value on women. And I strongly believe that things gonna get changed, and it's gonna get better from day to day, as you know, we are living in this world right now. And hopefully, just my message or my story can actually help someone to listen, or at least it help you to, you know, build this courage to do something for yourself. But just know that at the end of the day, you are doing it for yourself. You are not doing it for someone else. So I would end this by saying, you know, an officially goodbye in Cambodia, and I wish you all well. And hopefully this project can, you know, really help so many women out there. Okay. Thank you, and chumrip lia.